Hi, this is Congressman John Sarbanes. In 2022, Congress took historic steps to strengthen our economy, fight climate change, protect public safety, and safeguard fundamental rights. Let me give you some highlights. We passed and President Biden signed the CHIPS and Science Act to bring American manufacturing home, fix our supply chains, and improve our global competitiveness. You may have seen recent news about the big new chip factory being built in Arizona. That's because of the CHIPS and Science Act. And those same kinds of investments are coming to Maryland. Another bill, the Inflation Reduction Act, will cut home energy expenses for consumers and increase clean energy production by American companies and American workers. It also takes on big pharma by reducing prescription drug prices. That's the right thing to do. Stand up for American families and demand accountability from the big corporations. But the bill does even more, making historic investment in reducing carbon emissions and strengthening climate resilience across every community. That aligns directly with our efforts to restore and protect the Chesapeake Bay. I'm proud that through this year's bipartisan federal spending bill, Congress delivered robust funding to meet our conservation goals and promote environmental stewardship in the Bay. Recognizing the importance of empowering the environmental stewards of the future, I introduced legislation to expand hands-on outdoor environmental education experiences in our schools. To meet the healthcare needs of our students, the bipartisan federal spending bill also included record funding for school-based health centers, which I have long supported to address health inequities in communities across Maryland. This year, Congress also passed and President Biden signed significant legislation that takes the most meaningful steps in decades to reduce the incidence of gun violence. By expanding background checks for Americans ages 18 to 21, closing the boyfriend loophole, making gun trafficking a federal crime, and encouraging states to enact red flag laws, this new law will save lives. Congress can and should do more, but this is an important step in the right direction. I also voted to provide law enforcement agencies with the resources and training to better protect themselves and the communities they serve, including by appropriately responding to individuals experiencing mental or behavioral health crises and supporting proven violence intervention and prevention programs. When it comes to fortifying our democracy, we did our part in the House of Representatives to strengthen access to the ballot box, fix partisan gerrymandering, prevent election subversion, and combat the influence of dark money on our politics. In the end, the Senate came up short on passing H.R. 1, my democracy reform legislation, but the fight for voting rights continues every day in every arena. The Supreme Court's decision overturning Roe v. Wade fueled new abortion bans in states across the country. While abortion remains legal in Maryland, we need to ensure access is protected in every state. That's why I voted for two bills passed by the House to create a statutory right to provide and receive abortion care and to protect contraception access nationwide. In its abortion decision, the Supreme Court also signaled its intention to strike down marriage equality. Congress responded swiftly by passing legislation that enshrines in federal law critical protections for same-sex and interracial marriage. All my efforts in Congress come down to this: constituent services. That's why I want Marylanders to know about a new law enacted this fall to expand access to care for our veterans, especially those exposed to toxic substances during their service. This law also establishes two new Department of Veterans Affairs outpatient clinics in Baltimore and Prince George's County to deliver much-needed services to the veterans in our state. It's also why I held a veterans benefits workshop in Severn to provide personalized assistance for Maryland veterans. If you or a veteran you know needs assistance, please do not hesitate to reach out to my office. I've enjoyed attending many constituent events across Maryland this year. Connecting with you is the best, most important part of my job. With the new redistricting, a number of you will now be represented by other members of our congressional delegation. But I wanted to let you know how appreciative I am for the input that you have given me as your representative in Washington. I wish you and your family a happy new year.